dear friend, we'll see some another definitions. First one, that is storage coefficient. The water yielding capacity of confined aquifer can be expressed in term of storage coefficient. So storage coefficient, this is for the confined aquifer. So water yielding capacity, that means how much water that can be taken up from the aquifer, can be expressed in term of storage coefficient. Now we see this figure. So this is a two layer, this is a hard strata, this is a hard strata. In between these two hard strata, this is a layer which is confined. So this is a aquifer, this is aquifer, this is a confined aquifer, as this is confined between two impervious layers. And when the well is drilled in this one, so water table will be like this. So this is a, again, this aquifer is an unconfined aquifer, this is a confined aquifer. Storage coefficient, it is defined as volume of water that aquifer releases per unit surface area of the aquifer. Now you see, this is a 1 by 1 meter unit area. So volume of water that aquifer releases per unit surface area of the aquifer per unit change in component of head. So if the 1 meter by 1 meter column, by reducing this head by 1 meter, how much volume of water that we can get, that we can expect from this unconfined aquifer, is known as storage coefficient. This is again definition you have to keep in mind from competitive examination point of view. Then another definition, that is coefficient of permeability. This is denoted by K. It is defined by, or defined as, the velocity of flow through cross-sectional area of the soil or aquifer under unit hydraulic gradient. Then another definition, that is coefficient of transmissibility, T. It is defined as a rate of flow of water through a vertical strip of unit width and extended to the full saturated height under unit hydraulic gradient at a temperature of 60 degree Fahrenheit, denoted by T equal to B into K, where B is a depth of confined aquifer and K is a coefficient of permeability. Now we'll see how this discharge through well are calculated. Now let's say well hydraulics. Well hydraulics is a Darcy's law. The percolation of the water through the soil was experimented by Darcy and demonstrated by the Darcy that for a laminar flow condition in a saturated soil, rate of flow or a discharge per unit time is proportional to the hydraulic gradient and can be expressed as. So Darcy has given his equation and he has demonstrated that rate of flow per unit time is proportional to the hydraulic gradient, and this can be explained as Q equal to KIA, where Q is a rate of flow, K is a Darcy's coefficient of permeability, I is a hydraulic gradient, and A is a cross-sectional area. So here, A is a cross-sectional area perpendicular to the flow direction. This equation is applicable for laminar flow only. Laminar flow occurs when aquifer is of fine grain soil, while if it is a coarse grain soil, in that case flow may be turbulent. This equation is not valid. So this Darcy's equation is valid for Reynolds number rho Vd by mu less than or equal to 1. So where rho is a mass density, mu is a dynamic viscosity, V is a velocity of flow, D is a diameter of particle, and this law is applicable within a limit. Then for a rock aquifer, in unconsolidated aquifer with a steep gradient or for the large opening diameter, Darcy's law is not applicable. Then we see steady radial flow to a well or dipit steady. When a well is penetrated in a homogeneous aquifer, when the vein is penetrated in homogeneous aquifer, initially water table remains horizontal. As the water is pumped out, then the water table or a piezometric surface, depending on the type of aquifer, is lowered, and resulting is circular depression in a water table or a piezometric surface. This depression is called cone of depression or drawdown curve. Now you see here, this is a well. This is a ground level. This is a well which is penetrated, and this is a impervious strata. Now when there is only impervious strata and this is an aquifer, and top portion is indicated by the water table, this is which type of aquifer? This is an unconfined aquifer, because this aquifer is not confined by the two layers. So it's an unconfined aquifer. Now this is a well which is penetrated, well of radius R, this is a Q. In normal, when the only well is penetrated, this water level would have been like this. But when the discharge is started, when the water is pumped up, as soon as water pumped up, so this, there will be depression of this water level, and such type of curve will occur. So this will be, this is known as a cone of depression. So cone of depression, and this, suppose from this level water is lower down to this one, so this curve like this, and this is known as a cone of depression. From this cone of depression, water is enter in the well, and this will be like this. Now if you consider this as a O origin, x axis, y axis, this R, that is a radius of influence where this drawdown is zero. So this vertical distance from this initial water level to this level is known as a drawdown. So S is a drawdown. If this is another well, so this is original, this is lowering, so this is a drawdown, S1. Similarly, S2 is drawdown. Now here, how much is the drawdown? Zero drawdown. So this distance from the center of the well to the point where drawdown is zero is known as a range of well. So this is a range. Normally this range is about 300 meters. Now here, in this figure, R is a radius of well, H is the thickness of aquifer. So from impervious to the water table level, H is the thickness of aquifer. So S is the drawdown, small h is the depth of water above the impervious layer after drawdowning. Okay, so then Q equal to K Ix into Ax. Q is equal to K into Ix into Ax, because Q equal to KIA. So we are considering any point P here at a distance X and Y. So X, Y, any P point. So how much will be the Q? Q will be K Ix Ax at P. So what is Ix? Gradient, that is dy by dx. What is Ax? Ax, area. So area X, 2πx, 2πx with the circle, into Y. This will be cylinder from which water is entering. So therefore, this Ax equal to 2 pi x into y, 2 pi xy, Ix equal to dy by dx, and Q equal to, therefore Q equal to K into 2 pi xy into dy by dx, and this limits for this, by rearranging this, and limits for this x is from small r to capital R, because limits will be like this, from this R to capital R, and limits of Y will be from this small h to capital H. By substituting these limits here, you will get Q equal to this one. So Q equal to pi k h square minus h square upon log of R by R, this is to the base E. So for to the base 10, Q equal to this one. So this is a formula for discharge through unconfined aquifer, that is pi k h square minus h square 2.73 log to the base 10 r by r, and this r is the range, 300 s root k. Normal this is 150 to 300 meter. So this is value of r. Now next topic we will see in next video.